So with the introduction of Soul Fusion, this set gives us a new for hire monster, or should I say, monster for hire, in the name of Folgo, Justice for Hire. What does this card do, and how good is it for the deck? Well, in this episode of Deck Check, I'm going over for hire post Soul Fusion. So this episode is mainly going to be focused around Folgo, and to focus the episode around Folgo, I obviously need to state its effect. So its effect is as follows. 3 monsters with different types. Cannot be used as link material. If this card is link summoned, you can special summon one monster for hire with a different type from the 3 monsters used for the link summon from your deck and defense position. If a card your opponent controls is destroyed by battle or card effect, you can draw 1 card. Then if you control 3 or more monsters for hire with different names, draw 2 additional cards. You can only use each effect of Folgo Justice for Hire once per turn. So first off, let me just start by stating the fact that this card is absolutely
insane.
The first part I'm going to analyze about this effect is the fact that it special summons one monster for hire from your deck. This is incredibly useful as the for hire monsters actually give you quite a lot of utility. Let's start with, for example, Rafale. Rafale has an effect when on summon, you can excavate cards equal to the number of monsters you have on the field with different names that are for hire monsters, excavate a number of cards equal to the number of different names, and then you get to pick one and add it to your hand. So what that means is if you easily summon Folgo, you can special summon a Rafale from your deck and just be able to get a free plus one from that. As well, Rafale is a free monster negate. So if you have a for hire card in your hand, you can easily negate a monster effect through that. While that's very powerful, if you have another for hire monster in your hand, you can also special summon Beat in order to special summon another for hire from your hand. And then from there, you can use Beat effect in order to search for Rafale. Rafale can then special summon itself, and then because you have 4 for hires with different names on the field, Rafale digs you 4 cards deeper instead of just 2. Also, with that for hire you summoned, it could be a card like Seal, Strategist for Hire. So what that means is when you summon Seal, you can recur another for hire from your graveyard, getting you more and more advantage over time. You can start seeing how this starts getting crazier by the second as you have more for hire monsters in your hand. Another example is special summoning Dampa from your hand. Dampa is the level 2 beast that destroys a face-up card on the field when another for hire is special summoned to your field. So the reason why you would want to special summon Dampa is A, it's your turn, you're going second, you're trying to clear your opponent's field, and you summon something with Dampa in order to clear some of their cards, or if it's your turn, you can also summon Dampa as a disruption. So for example, with Mayhem for Hire, it's basically a quick play monster reborn for hire monsters. Unfortunately, it cannot summon Folgo since Folgo is a link monster, but that's not the point here. You can send Mayhem for Hire and summon the Dampa with Folgo, and then on your opponent's turn, you can activate the Mayhem for Hire, special summoning a for hire from your graveyard, because most of the time you should have a for hire in your graveyard if you summon Folgo, and from there you can trigger Dampa effect to pop a card your opponent controls. Then where this gets even more crazy is with the other effect Folgo possesses, which that effect is the draw 3 effect. Obviously, it says draw 1, but most of the time you will actually have 3 or more monsters with for hire in their name with different names on the field, getting you the additional 2 cards. So if you couldn't tell, drawing 3 cards is a big deal in the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! There's a reason why cards like Pot of Greed and Graceful Charity are banned. Pot of Greed obviously is a plus 1 just generically, which is actually ridiculous, and Graceful Charity digs you 3 cards deeper. But the fact is, Folgo gets you 3 draws without any cost. All you have to do is destroy a card by battle or card effect that your opponent controls. To put this in perspective, let's take a card like Pot of Desires. Pot of Desires requires you to banish the top 10 cards of your deck face down in order to draw 2, which you should play Pot of Desires in this deck as it's again a plus 1. While that's a hefty cost, this card, not looking at the cost of summoning it and everything, not only gets you a special summon from deck, but as well gets you this incredible secondary effect that basically replenishes your hand. And if you can resolve this effect once, you just basically won the game. Now you might be wondering, why is it not that hard to put 3 monsters with different names that are for hire monsters on the field? Well, think about it this way. Folgo Justice for Hire has for hire in its name, making it a for for hire monster. That's one monster. Then Folgo special summons another for hire from your deck, putting two monsters on the field. If you're going for that same disruption play I already described, where you special summon Damba from your deck and you have Mayhem set, that's basically a third for hire monster, as you're special summoning one from your graveyard in order to trigger Damba, which then destroys a card, and then that will trigger Folgo. And because you have three for hire monsters on the field, that draws you three cards, and that's very powerful, especially in a deck like for a hire that goes through resources very quickly. This effect is absolutely what the deck needed, and as well the special from deck effect is also what the deck needed. This card gives quite a lot to the deck. However, there are some issues that I will get to right now. To start with one of the smaller issues, this card can't be used as link material. You might think, oh, that's not a big deal. However, sometimes if you would want to go for a card like Gumblar or a card like Saryuja. Because remember, people play Saryuja in this deck. Unfortunately, you can't summon it with this card. However, that doesn't change the fact that it doesn't really actually matter that much. If you think about it, you usually just want to have Folgo on the field to continuously draw you three cards every single turn. So it's not that big of a deal, but I thought I would mention it, considering it is definitely something to know. However, I think the biggest issue with this card is the fact that it requires three monsters with different types as material. So there are a multitude of issues with this summoning condition. The first issue is for hire is incredibly normal summon reliant. If you normal summon B and you attempt to use its effect and then your opponent chains infinite impermanence or widow anchor, then you're actually kind of just screwed. The fact is you really need that first effect to resolve, and if it doesn't resolve, then you're really in a bad position. Considering this, there aren't a lot of cards that enable you to put two monsters on the field very consistently with different types. One way of doing this is with a card like Sky Striker Mecha Hornet Drones. This is by far the best card in the strategy that's not actually a part of the strategy. Considering the fact that it puts two monsters with different types on the field incredibly easily. Remember, you just summon a token, get Kagari effects, grab it back, summon the token again, and boom, there are two monsters on the field without using your normal summon. This is incredibly consistent and doesn't ask for much at all. This is the best card by far in order to play through just your normal summon. But then the issue is Hornet Drones is limited to one. Now, yes, you can play three copies of Engage, but then they become dead draws later in the game. Personally, I would run Engage considering the fact that Hornet Drones is probably the best card in the deck and you want to see it as soon as possible for the strategy. However, I just wanted to note that it can be dead at times. You need to play other targets as well. So overall, it might not be as good to run more, but you have to run at least one Hornet Drones. However, if Hornet Drones was at three copies, that would be significantly better, considering the fact that you have three Hornet Drones, which is amazing for the strategy, and then you can play three Engage without the concern as much of playing dead cards. However, let's say we don't draw Hornet Drones, then what do we do? Well, we can run cards that just special summon themselves for free. However, then we still need to put out more materials in order to commit to this play. The beauty of the Hornet Drones engine is the fact that it puts out two materials for the price of one. That is incredibly important to note. And the fact is, in order to put out three materials, you obviously need to commit three cards. Now, you might think, oh, but you get three draws. However, the issue is this card is easily interruptible. For example, the play where you summon Dampa with Folgo and then set Mayhem requires a lot to go through and resolve. If a Widow Anchor occurs, well, you just committed all of those resources to that one play and it didn't work out. You can easily get rid of Folgo, and just overall, it's really hard sometimes for this deck to get going. However, once this deck does get going, it's honestly really hard to stop. Engage gets you a +2, but so does Folgo. And Folgo does this every single time you destroy an opponent's card. Two honorable mentions I have, the first being Ghost Ogre for the strategy. Ghost Ogre is obviously a hand trap, making it significantly better than a lot of other options. But as well, Ghost Ogre is able to trigger Folgo. This is incredibly important to note, as it's actually very powerful. Ghost Ogre is a very powerful card this format, being able to stop cards like Summon Sorceress. However, not good in every matchup, Ghost Ogre is still very important to the strategy in order to draw three cards so much easier. Overall, you 100% need to play Ghost Ogre at 3 copies, not only as a disruption and a hand trap, but as a combo piece. The second card I will also mention is Back to the Front and Call of the Haunted. These cards help you achieve that Dompa play where you can set it up and be able to draw 3 cards on your opponent's turn. I personally feel Back to the Front is just a better card for this slot, but overall I wanted to mention both just in case. However, before you play 3 Back to the Front or any Back to the Front at all, you need to play 3 copies of Mayhem, because Mayhem is just generically better than both of those cards in this strategy, as it's a quick play spell card rather than a trap. So overall, on a scale of 1 to 5 for higher, I give it a 3 for higher, as it's definitely a decent rogue deck. However, it is 100% very normal summon reliant, can be very linear in play, and can't always get going. As I've stated or earlier, with cards like Widow Anchor and Infinite Impermanence easily able to stop the draw 3 effect on Folgo. However, despite all of that, if you can resolve Folgo, you should actually just win that game usually. And overall, I think Folgo is a really amazing card and helps the strategy quite immensely. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I greatly appreciate the support. However, if you want to support me further than just watching my videos, go down into the description and support me through Patreon. This helps me quite immensely, and I am very grateful for your support. If you want to talk to me as well further than just the YouTube comment section, go down into the description and join my Discord server. I'd love to have you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And with that, I'll see you guys next time.